Welcome to CEC Online Lectures. I am Arunesh Dwivedi and today we will discuss about the news writing for the newspapers. Mass media students have to read a subject which is known as print media and newspaper production. In some universities, this paper is also known as print journalism and program production. So basically, in this subject, there is a unit which is based on the news writing for the newspapers. So in this lecture, we will discuss what is the principle of news writing, what are the various formats of news writing for the newspapers. Apart from that, we will also discuss what is feature writing and what is the writing format for the magazines. So if we talk about the print journalism, as you know that print media is the oldest media in the world and of course in our country also. So print journalism is the major component of mass media, and print journalism basically deals the information which needs to be collected and processing and then the dissemination of that information. What does it mean? It means in journalism, the basic definition is same, but the presentation of the content is different by different as per the need of the media. It means for the newspaper, the news get printed and the same news is get broadcast for the TV channels. Okay. And in multimedia journalism, there is everything. There is a text, there is a video, there is a audio. So basically all these are the mediums through which the news is broadcast to its viewers. So if we talk about the types of the newspaper, so as you know, basically there are two types of the newspaper, and this category or this classification is based on their size, their news content presentation. So there are two kinds of the newspaper. The first one is broadsheet newspaper and the second one is tabloid newspaper. The in broadsheet newspaper, it generally deals with the hard stories, political stories, crime, sports, entertainment, everything is there. But they don't focus on the more on celebrity kind of the journalism, scandals and all. Also, there are some news related to that also. But the second category is tabloid newspaper, and such kind of the newspaper mostly focuses on scandals. They promote the news stories related to the celebrities, and that celebrities can be from any field, from Bollywood, from politics, from any sector, you know. So you can say that in broadsheet newspaper, there is a editorial page, opposite editorial page, which is also known as op-ed page. And basically you can say the difference is based on their size. If you talk about the examples, then the major newspapers of the country like Times of India, Hindustan, Times, Dainik Jagran, Dainik Bhaskar, etc. All these are the examples of broadsheet newspapers. But if we talk about the Midday is a very famous newspaper of Mumbai. So this is the example of tabloid newspaper. There is another newspaper, DNA. Recently this newspaper has got dismissed. Only the soft copy of DNA is available. They have stopped to print the hard copy. And another example is Mint. Mint is a business newspaper which is promoted by the Hindustan Times Group. This is the sister company of Hindustan Times Group. And if we talk about the some more newspapers which is formulated by the India Today Group. दैट न्यूज पेपर ऑल्सो कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ टेबलॉइड न्यूज पेपर. सो हियर द बेसिक क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टेबलॉइड न्यूज पेपर एंड ब्रॉडशीट न्यूज पेपर. तो द फर्स्ट डिफरेंस इज दैट कि ब्रॉडशीट न्यूज पेपर्स मोस्टली फोकस ऑन द स्पोर्ट्स पॉलिटिक्स एंड ऑल द इम्पोर्टेंट इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू करेंट अफेयर्स, वाइल द टेबलॉइड न्यूज पेपर मोस्टली दे फोकसेस ऑन द स्कैंडल्स, फोकसेस ऑन द बॉलीवुड रिलेटेड स्टोरीज, गॉसिप्स एटसेट्रा. सो बेसिकली यू कैन से देर इज ए डिफरेंस बिटवीन द कंटेंट सिलेक्शन एंड गेट कीपिंग प्रोसेस. एंड गेट कीपिंग थ्योरी ऑफ मास मीडिया इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थ्योरी वेयर ईच कंटेंट इज बेसिकली डिसाइडेड वेदर इट शुड गो टू पब्लिश और नॉट. एंड द सेकेंड डिफरेंस इज दैट ब्रॉडशीट न्यूज पेपर बेसिकली एम्स टू इन्फॉर्म द रीडर्स, वाइल द टेबलॉइड न्यूज पेपर एम इज टू एंटरटेन द readers. So this is the difference. And another difference also lies on the photographs. Basically in broadsheet there are less photographs and more text, and this is just opposite in the case of tabloid newspaper. These are the some basic differences you can say. And language, sentence formation, creative and catchy headlines, these are the some similarities also. So basically if we talk about the what is the difference between the size also matters. So if we talk about the broadsheet newspaper, then its size is 600 into 750 millimeters. But if it is converted to inch, then it may be around 23 into 29 inch. And if you talk about the tabloid, the size of tabloid newspaper, then of course in millimeters it is 280 into 430 millimeters, and in inch this is 11 into 16th inch. So this is the size of broadsheet and tabloid newspaper. So the most common types of newspapers are broadsheet, Berliner, tabloid and compact. So these cut sizes are generally the sizes that we refer to when talking about the size of newspapers, because these are the sizes in which newspapers are delivered to our homes. So if we talk about the what are the basic principles of news writing, so news writing is almost same, but it depends on the format of news writing. For example, if you are writing a news story for the television, then it should be written in a conversational style, that anchor is basically interacting with his viewers. In the same way, if you are writing a news story for radio, then it should be written for the ears, that that makes a great sense of listening. In the same way, if you are writing a news story for the newspaper or magazines, then it should be written for the eyes. Do you know why? Because when you see the headlines of a newspaper, then it catches the attention through your eyes. So you should write the headlines in a very creative, catchy and crispy way. So what are the other important points that one should keep in mind while he or she is writing the news story for the newspapers? So the first one is KISS formula, KISS, keep it simple and short. So the sentences in the news stories average 20 to 25 words, not more than that. So do not string together with commas, conjunctions, several sentences into one long sentence. So just split one long sentences to small sentences. So it is better that you should write simple sentence using simple language, that is actually understandable by the your reader. The second important point is short paragraph. Remember, you are not writing an essay, you are writing a news story. So you have to write a small paragraphs. There are some news stories in which paragraph should be not more than 3 to 5 sentences. So this is also very important, that short paragraphs should be written. And this is much different from the writing you had done for your composition and English classes. As I have already told you, that you are writing a news story. You are not writing an essay. So this is also an important point. And if we talk about some more important elements of news writing for the newspapers, then there are many stories in which there is a third person. So a news story should be written completely in the third person. Example, he, she, it, or they. Except when you see to use a person's own words in a direct quotation. So this is also an important point. Next point is nouns and verbs. This is the grammar. I hope you must have heard and you know already about what is grammar. So in TV, there is a visual grammar. It means you have to write down the script according to the visuals. So in newspaper, you have to focus on the language, the noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, etc. So place emphasis more on the noun and verb than on adjective and adverb. More focus on noun and verb. Less focus on the adjective and adverb. So this is also a very important point. And you should also keep in mind that action verbs keep a story moving and grab the readers more than to be verbs. To be verb means is, I am, are, was, were. So which shows a little action. So use action verbs to describe what you are observing. And there is another important point is simple writing. I have already told you that you have to write simple sentences, simple paragraph, simple language. It doesn't mean that you are using a mean language, which mostly, teenagers or adults using with their friend circle. In their personal life, they can use what language they prefer. But in professional life, you have to follow some code of conduct. So basically, every newspaper has the style sheet in which all the basic information is written. And everyone has to follow the rules and regulations, the guidelines that is mentioned in their style sheet. So simple writing is also very important. Use simple words, simple sentences. Don't use complex words like उच्चतम न्यायालय ने आज ये फैसला देते हुए कहा या सर्वोच्च न्यायालय. So ये दोनों शब्द अच्छे हैं, लेकिन अगर इनकी जगह आप हाई कोर्ट या सुप्रीम कोर्ट का प्रयोग करते हैं तो आपका जो रीडर है वो उसको ज्यादा अच्छे से समझ पाएगा. या कोरोना के इस अवसर पर 200 लौह पथगामी चलाई जाएंगी, सरकार का ऐलान. तो अगर लौह पथगामी आप लिखेंगे जो कि ट्रेन की टिपिकल हिंदी है तो बहुत से लोगों को समझ में नहीं आएगा. आप सिंपल रेलगाड़ी लिखिए, ट्रेन लिखिए, वो ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है. उसी तरीके से अगर हम बात करें कुछ और इंपॉर्टेंट एलिमेंट्स की, तो उसमें एक है जार्गन्स. सो जार्गन्स दे आर नॉट कंसिडर्ड वेरी गुड फॉर द न्यूज राइटिंग. सो बेसिकली आपको ये ध्यान रखना है कि डोंट यूज जार्गन्स, ज्यादा जार्गन्स का प्रयोग ना करें. तो सवाल उठता है जार्गन्स होते क्या है. सो यू हैव टू अवॉइड द जार्गन्स. एंड जार्गन इज ए टेक्निकल लैंग्वेज व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू स्पेशलाइज्ड फील्ड और इन स्पेसिफिक ग्रुप्स. वाइल क्लिचेज, दीज आर द ओवर यूज्ड वर्ड्स एंड फ्रेजेस सच एज इट कॉस्ट एन आर्म एंड ए लेग, ए ड्रॉप इन द बकेट एंड ऑन द कटिंग एज. सो you have to avoid all these things. Don't use complex word, don't use jargons and all. And if you talk about the transition, ट्रांजिशन इज ए ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. तो ट्रांजिशन बेसिकली टाई टूगेदर व्हाट यू हैव रिटन. ई सेंटेंस इन ए स्टोरी शुड लॉजिकली फॉलो द प्रीवियस सेंटेंस. मतलब देर इज ए यू नो कंटिन्यूटी इन योर न्यूज स्टोरी. एंड इसको पीपीएफ फॉर्मेट भी कहा जाता है कि इन द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ यू हैव टू टेल अबाउट द व्हाट इज द प्रेजेंट अपडेट ऑन द स्टोरी. देन सेकेंड पी इज पास्ट कि बैकग्राउंडर क्या है स्टोरी का. एंड द थर्ड वन इज एफ यानी फ्यूचर अब इस स्टोरी का क्या असर होने जा रहा है. सो ये भी ट्रांजिशन भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. इसी में से कनेक्टर्स आता है. जो ट्रांजिशंस के बेसिकली तीन इंपॉर्टेंट एलिमेंट्स होते हैं, एक कनेक्टर्स होता है, दूसरा हुक होता है, तीसरा प्रोनाउंस होता है. तो प्रोनाउन में क्या होता है, हुक में क्या होता है, कनेक्टर्स में क्या होता है, अब हम इसके बारे में बात करेंगे. तो बेसिकली कनेक्टर हेल्प टू यूनिफाई द राइटिंग. फॉर द मोस्ट पार्ट दे आर कंजक्शंस सच एज एंड, बट, और, फॉर, दस, हाउ एवर, देयर फोर, मीन व्हाइल एंड अदर्स. व्हाइल इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द हुक्स, so basically hooks are the words or the phrases that are repeated throughout an article to give the readers a sense of unity. And the pronoun, this is the best transition devices for writing about the people. Instead of using a person's name each time, don't use his name each time, and you can use a pronoun for that. So after transition there is a quotations. You can start your story by saying some quotations. Mostly in the feature kind of the stories, it is better to start with the quotations. So quotations are the words of someone talking. It is a good idea to use the quotation to bring life into your story. Quotations can be either direct or indirect. A direct quotation is the exact words of a person talking or quoted in a news story, while an indirect quotation, which is also known as paraphrase, this may have one word or a few of the same words that a speaker used. Another important point is attribution. Attribution means to tell the reader where the information in a story comes from. Attribution is extremely important in a news writing. It is one way writers can avoid editorializing in their story by making sure that the information in their stories can be attributed to someone or some organization. So this is also a very important point. Now let's talk about the numbers. आपने देखा होगा कई बार जब फाइनेंस की स्टोरी जाती है, बजट पेश किया जाता है, तो बड़े बड़े नंबर्स होते हैं, बड़े बड़े आंकड़े होते हैं. तो नंबर्स को कैसे लिखा जाए, ये भी एक इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है. सो इन जनरल स्पेल आउट होल नंबर्स 9 एंड बिलो. सो डोंट राइट 9 नंबर्स इन न्यूमेरिक सिस्टम. यू कैन राइट द नंबर्स इन वर्ड्स, 9,50,000, 70,000, 50. सो वर्ड्स में लिखने से क्या होता है कि वो ज्यादा बेटर रहता है टीवी के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में. लेकिन अगर हम बात न्यूज़पेपर के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में करें तो ये होता है कि आप नंबर्स को जो है वर्ड्स में भी लिख सकते हैं, लेकिन एक राउंड अप फिगर लिखो तो ज्यादा बेटर रहता है. सो यू हैव टू यूज फिगर फॉर 10 एंड अबव. That the 25 boys, million and billion, these are also used for the round numbers. Thousands are the numbers. Ages are always the numbers. The 2 years old girl or 21 years old boy has committed suicide and all, So basically you have to use the number. Measurement and dimensions are always in the numbers. 25%, 3 yards. Yeah, he is 5 feet tall. And ears, ears are also numbers. So this is also important. And now let's talk about what are the famous structure of news writing. So inverted pyramid style of news writing. This is the oldest format of news writing. And this is applicable for all the media. It may be, print media, electronic media or digital media. But you have to focus on what are the various important elements of inverted pyramid style. So basically you must have heard the name of 5W N1H. सो 5W एंड 1H मीन्स हु व्हाट व्हेन व्हेयर व्हाई एंड हाउ. सो द 5 W's एंड 1 H ऑल्सो कैन बी द क्वेश्चन दैट ए न्यूज स्टोरी शुड आंसर. यानी एक स्टोरी में इन पांच जो बातें हैं, पांच W हैं, कब, कहां, क्यों, कैसे, तो कैसे में हाउ आ गया, तो इन सवालों के जवाब आपकी स्टोरी में मिलने चाहिए. जैसे कि एग्जांपल ले कि हु सेड और डिड समथिंग, किसने क्या कहा या क्या किया, या व्हाट वाज सेड और डन, व्हाट हैपेंड, क्या हुआ, व्हेन वाज इट सेड और डन, व्हेन डिड इट हैपेंड, या व्हेयर वाज इट सेड और डन, व्हेयर डिड इट हैपेंड, व्हाई वाज इट सेड और डन एंड व्हाई डिड इट हैपेंड, एंड हाउ वाज इट सेड और डन एंड हाउ डिड इट हैपेंड. अब जैसे प्रधानमंत्री जी कोई महत्वपूर्ण घोषणा कर रहे हैं, तो क्या घोषणा कर रहे हैं, क्या का जवाब मिल गया, किस पर वो अप्लीकेबल होगा, कहां से घोषणा कर रहे हैं, किसके लिए कर रहे हैं, क्यों कर रहे हैं, तो इन सारे सवालों का जवाब जो है आपको स्टोरी में होना चाहिए. और ये हर एक स्टोरी में होता है, ऐसा नहीं है सिर्फ पॉलिटिकल में ही हो. आप नॉर्मल अगर स्पोर्ट्स की स्टोरी में देखें तो कितने रनों से भारत जीता, कैसा परफॉर्मेंस कैसा रहा, या उसी तरीके से अगर आप एंटरटेनमेंट की स्टोरीज देखेंगे तो वहां पर भी अप्लीकेबल होता है, क्राइम की स्टोरीज में भी अप्लीकेबल होता है. सो आपको ये स्टोरी को जो है फॉलो करना चाहिए इस फॉर्मेट को जब न्यूज लिखते हैं. इसका एक दूसरा तरीका और भी है, व्हाट फार्मूला, WHAT. W मीन्स व्हाट, H मीन्स हाउ इट हैपेंड, A मीन्स एम्पलीफाई डिटेल एंड T मीन्स टाई टूगेदर. तो WHAT का जब फुल फॉर्म हमने आपको बताया कि व्हाट हैपेंड, हाउ इट हैपेंड, एम्पलीफाई डिटेल्स एंड टाई टूगेदर, तो इससे आप रिपोर्टर्स जब आप फील्ड में जाते हैं तो क्या होता है, सबसे पहले आप ये पता करेंगे, फिर उसकी डिटेल पता करेंगे, इसके बाद कैसे हुआ, कौन उसके जिम्मेदार लोग हैं, कौन कौन से एलिमेंट्स उस स्टोरी से रिलेटेड हैं, उन सबसे बात करने के बाद आप सारे तथ्यों को मिला करके एक स्टोरी को अनबायस्ड वे में फाइल करेंगे. इसके अलावा हम बात करते हैं दूसरे स्ट्रक्चर जिसका नाम है नैरेटिव स्ट्रक्चर. इन दिस स्ट्रक्चर बेसिकली यू हैव टू नैरेट द स्टोरी. अ रिपोर्टर यूजिंग दिस स्ट्रक्चर शुड बिगिन विद एन एंटीसिटोड इंट्रोड्यूसिंग अ करेक्टर हुज एक्सपीरियंस इलस्ट्रेट व्हाट द स्टोरी इज ऑल अबाउट. सो बेसिकली दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज मोस्टली यूज इन टीवी मीडिया. सो यू कैन सजेस्ट दैट if we talk about the newspaper, then you can write a good feature story by using the narrative structure of writing. So a narrative structure is a straightforward chronological description of the events. For example, an article about a set of murders, it may begin with the discovery of the first victim and end with the imprisonment or execution of a suspect. So basically you have to follow the chronological order. The next format is hourglass structure. Hourglass structure of writing is a combination of inverted pyramid and narrative structure. It means the author begins with the key details 5W and 1H and then add the details that is have the more importance in the inverted pyramid style. And basically, this has the three basic elements. The first one is the top, the turn, and the narrative. The top especially tells 5W and 1H, and it is written in the format of inverted pyramid style. It means the most important part of the story should be written first, then less important, and at last, least important information is written in your news story. So this is also very important element. And at last we should discuss about the writing for the magazines. As you know, the magazines are also important part of the print medium. Most of the magazines are based on the entertainment sector, lifestyle, sports, news and current affair based also. And there are specific magazines which are focuses on the competitive examinations. So we are talking about the news and current affair based magazines. So mostly such magazines comes weekly basis or monthly basis, or published once in 15 days. So आपको इसमें क्या करना है कि व्हाट यू हैव टू कीप इन योर माइंड व्हाइल यू आर राइटिंग फॉर द मैगजीन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट मैगजीन हैज ए बिगर स्पेस देन न्यूज़पेपर. So you can write your story in more than 3000 words, 2000 words. It depends on your topic, you know. So you have to, first important point is that you have to study about your target publication. You have to choose the topic, select the topic which belongs to your area of interest and your expertise. This is also important. The second point is you have to choose different news angles. Feature angles that make your story a very creative. So you have to study your chosen topic carefully and figure out the interesting angles that were not discussed before and those that will grab the attention of your target audience. जो सब लिख रहे हैं वही आप भी लिखेंगे तो कुछ अंतर नहीं रहा. कुछ different लिखिए, जिसको कहते हैं कि लकीर के फकीर मत बने रहिए. अपना लिखने का एक नया अंदाज डेवलप कीजिए. फीचर राइटिंग में आप ये कर सकते हैं और मैगजीन में तो आपको स्पेस ज्यादा मिलता है, वर्ड लिमिट ज्यादा होती है, तो आप उसमें भी अच्छा कर सकते हैं. और जो थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज द रिसर्च. डू द प्रॉपर रिसर्च बिफोर राइटिंग एनीथिंग. यूज फिगर्स, यूज स्टैटिक्स एज पर द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ योर यू नो टॉपिक. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो यू कैन राइट अ लॉन्ग आर्टिकल्स फॉर द मैगजीन्स एंड यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड दैट यू हैव टू फॉलो द बेसिक रूल्स ऑफ न्यूज राइटिंग व्हिच मे बी रिलेटेड टू न्यूज पेपर और द मैगजीन्स. सो आई होप यू हैव टू गेट अ बेसिक आइडिया ऑफ न्यूज राइटिंग for the newspapers.